Disclaimer, I know this is a Nintendo heavy episode and I know that I'm wearing a PlayStation shirt. I know it because I bought it and I put it on to film this video. Anyway, but really when you think about it, I'm talking about Gunpei Yokoi, the guy who basically proved that handheld gaming devices can be successful in the gaming market. And to be honest, if it wasn't for Gunpei Yokoi and him creating the successful Game & Watch series and the successful Game Boy and its future iterations, there may have never been other portable systems from other companies, like the Lynx, the Game Gear, or these two from Sony. When it comes to that, thank you, sir. Howdy, hey there, and hello. I'm Montez McCrary at TezoNerdo from thepractitioner.com, and welcome everybody to Practitioner Documented, or DOCT, a short form documentary series on various topics related to architecture, technology, video games, and professional wrestling. In this video game themed episode of DOCT, we'll be discussing the life, career, and the lasting legacy of the legendary video game designer and producer, Gunpei Yokoi. Now, let's get nerdy. Part 1. Who is Gunpei Yokoi? Born on September 10th, 1941 in Kyoto, Japan, Gunpei Yokoi would go on to earn an electronics degree from Doshisha University, also in Kyoto, and upon his graduation, Yokoi applied for a position at Nintendo in 1965, and he was eventually hired to maintain the assembly line machines used to manufacture its Hanafuda cards, translation here, as well as other various jobs within the company, including janitor. One day in 1966, then-president of Nintendo, Hiroshi Yamauchi, visited the Hanafuda factory Yokoi was working at and took notice of a toy, basically an extending arm that Yokoi made on his own time for his own amusement during any spare time as the company's machine maintenance man. Later, Yamauchi would order Yokoi to develop it as a proper product, later called the Ultra Hand, for the Christmas rush, and it became a huge success, selling over 1.2 million units, resulting in Yokoi being asked to work on other top-selling Nintendo toys, like the Ultra Scope, the Ultra Machine, and the Love Tester. Love Tester. Love Tester. Love Tester. While traveling on the train, Yokoi saw a bored businessman playing with an LCD calculator by pressing the buttons, which gave him the idea for a watch that doubled as a miniature video game pastime device, which would later become the Game & Watch series, a line of simple handheld electronic LCD games controlled by a series of face buttons with a screen that was painted with a static backdrop and monochromatic objects that appeared on screen. And in the whole process of making the Game & Watch, Yokoi also created the directional pad, or D-pad. Part 2. What is Gunpei Yokoi best known for? In 1981, Yamauchi appointed Yokoi to supervise on Donkey Kong, an arcade game created by Shigeru Miyamoto. And after the worldwide success of Donkey Kong, Yokoi continued to work with Miyamoto on the next Mario game, simply called Mario Brothers, where he even provided some ideas such as superhuman abilities to jump to high places without even dying. Also to fall from high places without even dying. In 1984, Yokoi was assigned to head up R&D1, the lead research and development team within Nintendo. Now, as the NES project within Nintendo was picking up some steam, Yokoi's team contributed both hardware as well as software for the landmark console. R&D1 created the Robotic Operating Buddy, or ROB peripheral, as well as two iconic NES games, Metroid and Kid Icarus, and some other titles like Kid Icarus of Myths and Monsters for Game Boy, Dr. Mario, Fire Emblem, Balloon Kid, Super Mario Land, and Super Mario Land 2 6 Golden Coins for the Game Boy as well. Gee, I wonder what I'm gonna talk about next. After members of R&D1 split to form Intelligent Systems, a first-party developer for Nintendo, Yokoi and the remaining team returned to a brand new project And after the grand success of the Game & Watch series due to its portability and its low cost, Yokoi's team used those two goals in the development of the Game Boy, which was a monochromatic handheld device that used cartridges similar to the NES. And upon its release in 1989, the Game Boy was an instant worldwide success, selling out in both Japan and in America. And Yokoi also played a role in the Game Boy successor, the Game Boy Color. Part 3. What is the lasting legacy of Gunpei Yokoi? Unfortunately, all winning streaks eventually end, as in 1995, Nintendo released the brand new Yokoi creation, the Virtual Boy, which is widely considered as one of the highest profile flops in video games. Now, while the Virtual Boy did indeed create a reasonable 3D effect, the console itself was very clumsy and quickly earned a reputation for causing serious eye strain due to the system's red and black graphics. Now, after the system sort of just really stumbled out of the gate, it never truly recovered, as Nintendo then canceled release plans for the Virtual Boy in Europe and just altogether ended system support. The Virtual Boy debacle wasn't solely responsible, but it played a part in Yokoi's decision to resign from Nintendo on August 5th, 1996, ending his 31-year career at the company. After leaving Nintendo, Yokoi started his own company called Koto Laboratory. Yokoi and his engineering team went back to work in video games and oversaw the development of the WonderSwan handheld console for Bandai, which was no surprise considering he essentially created the successful portable video game market over at Nintendo with the Game & Watch series and with the Game Boy. But sadly, Yokoi would never see the release of the WonderSwan. On October 4th, 1997, while Yokoi, age 56, was driving on the Hokuriku Expressway with his associate Etso Kiso, they were rear-ended by a truck. And as they left the car to inspect the damage, Yokoi was fatally struck and hit by two passing cars and was ultimately pinned between the two vehicles. And his death was confirmed 2 hours later. But at the 2003 Game Developers Conference, Yokoi posthumously received a Lifetime Achievement Award of the International Game Developers Association, and GameTrailers.com placed him on their list for the top 10 game creators. For more about Gunpei Yokoi, check out IGN's From Janitor to Superstar write-up from 2009, Jeremy Parrish's Gunpei Yokoi video from his Game Boy World YouTube series, and go play some of the games that he worked on that I discussed in this video. I mean, it's not like I have to give you guys an excuse to play video games, right? Before we close here, I'm Montez McCrary at Tezo Nerdo from thepractitioner.com, and thank you guys so very much for your time. Please like, share, and subscribe to the channel. Follow The Practitioner on all the social networks. Shop at The Practitioner Zazzle store and with our affiliate links. And remember to stay true to yourself, stay blessed, and stay nerdy. Ugh.